that he loves them and that he's coming soon, and unless we repent, we will perish. It's very clear.
Amen.
God created us to have a relationship with him. Now we can go on in our life, and we can go to work, and we can go home, and we can club, and we can party, we can watch TV, we can do all of our things. But if we don't live a life for Jesus Christ, we stand before him and it all perishes. None of it matters.
Can I get some damn?
There's a lie that says you only live once, but the Bible says we live once and then after that the judgment. We're gonna stand before God and we're gonna be accountable for everything we did. Everything we did in this life, we will give an account for. Now, this is not a message to condemn anybody. This is not a message of judgment. This is a message of salvation to say, come. All of you who are weary, who carry heavy burdens, come and Jesus Christ will give you rest. There is nothing on this earth that is worth your salvation. But the very clear message is this. If you don't know God, how do you expect to die and go to heaven? If you don't serve God now, you won't be interested in serving him for eternity in heaven. So how doesn't make sense. God has given every man an opportunity to know him right now. This life is like a deep breath in and a deep breath out. It's over just as soon as it begins. And eternity does not end. What will you have to show for your life when you stand before God? We cannot run from this reality. The reality is we will stand before him. The reality is that he loves us, but our sin does separate us from us. And this is the bad news. But the good news is Jesus Christ came to this earth. He lived a perfect life. He was without sin. He walked among the people, healing the sick, casting out demons. He preached the gospel of repentance, for the kingdom of God is at hand. And he was a light to those around him. He is coming now to say that this world is in darkness, but he is the light. You know it and I know it. There's many evil things that happen in this world. There's many evil things that we face every day. And it's a hopeless kind of world. But Jesus Christ promises that he will be with us. If we put our faith in him, he will be with us. He doesn't promise us a perfect life. He promises us a life where when everything is said and done, he will say, well done. We will be able to enter into his kingdom, not because of our goodness or how much good we've done. It doesn't matter how many times you've fed the homeless. It doesn't matter how many times you've clothed somebody. All that matters is if you are forgiven of your sin. And my question today is, do you know Jesus Christ? Have you been forgiven? Jesus Christ is extending his hand today. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. So if I go to work every single day, I expect to get my paycheck. In the same way, if we sin, you can expect death. God is so serious about sin, he pays us with the death penalty. Every man will die. You have not met one person who will not die because God is serious about sin. So therefore, every man dies. And this is terrible news. But Jesus Christ said he came to bring life. He said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. And then he said, no one comes to the Father except through me. This lie that all roads lead to God, all roads lead to heaven, all religions are saying the same thing. It's a lie. All roads don't lead to God, and all religions don't lead to God. Jesus Christ lived. Muhammad is dead. Buddha is dead. Krishna is dead. But Jesus Christ is alive.
Amen.
Jesus Christ resurrected. If you don't want to believe it by faith, your history books will tell you that there were countless eyewitnesses of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Amen. If you don't want to read the Bible, you can go ahead and read a history book. People cannot erase him. The truth is, Jesus Christ is very real. He says, come. This is not a message of condemnation. This is a message that says, come, just as you are. But I promise you, he's so good, you won't stay as you are. He's not telling you to get it all together. He's telling you he wants to fix your life. And some of you don't think you need fixing. Some of you think, I'm pretty good. You know, my life is blessed. You know, I've got this, I've got that. And you say, well, God gave it to me. Well, yes, God allows it to rain on the wicked and on the just. Am I calling you wicked? No. I'm just telling you that it's very clear that you can have many things in your life, and that doesn't mean that God is pleased with us. The only way we have peace with God is if we repent and we get baptized and he gives us his Holy Spirit. That is a brand new life. Jesus Christ has commanded all those who believe in him to repent. That means turn from your sins. He says, get baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, and he promises to give you the Holy Spirit. Many of you under the sound of my voice, maybe this is the first time you're hearing this. Maybe you've heard this all your life. I'm telling you, don't harden your heart. God has a plan for you. God loves you with the everlasting love. He's calling you to himself. He loves you, and because he loves you, he sends people to warn us. Just the way a father loves his child, just the way a father wants to correct his child, in the same way God corrects us, in the same way God loves us. The truth is, we focus too much on this life. What can we accomplish in this life? What can we earn? What can we do? But we don't think about the afterlife. My question today is, have you thought about your eternity? Something as serious as our salvation, as our soul. You know and I know that there's nobody who has lived and not died. So if we know that we're gonna die, why don't we prepare for eternity? Some of you think, oh, nothing happens after death. You just go into the ground. The Bible says that the soul of man was given by man. He breathed life into our body, and our soul will go and it will stand before the God who gave it. We will all stand before God on the day of judgment. So my question is God happy with you or angry with you? I can tell you a little bit about me. I lived my life the way I wanted to. I was my own God. I called the shots. What I wanted to do, that's what I did. I didn't withhold any kind of pleasure from myself. I did what I wanted, and I did it when I wanted. But let me tell you about the God who came and shook my life up. My life is completely different now because God asked me very simply, are you ready for me? I'm coming soon. Are you ready for me? You can deny and deny and deny and say, oh, no, not in my lifetime. Oh, no, not me. But we're all going to stand before God. Every last one of us. And let me ask you this. If you walked into a place and they told you, ma'am, sir, the test that you're about to take, I want to let you know, many people have come in here and they've taken this test and many people have failed. You would say to yourself, I need to prepare for this test. In the same way, Jesus Christ says that the road to destruction is very wide and many people are on it. And the road to eternal life is very narrow and few find it. What does that mean? It means many people will stand before God and they will realize, and it'll be too late, they'll realize that no, I did not live a life that pleased God. And we can't do it in our own strength. I'm telling you that my life is different because I said, yes, Jesus. If you are willing, he is willing. It doesn't matter what's going on in your life right now. There's no disease that God cannot heal. There's no bondage that God cannot set you free from. There's no thought he can't set you free from. There's no depression you can't be set free from. There's no anxiety that Jesus Christ can't heal you of. Jesus Christ is saying, come. And then he says, if you hear my voice, do not harden your heart. He loves you. Anyone that will tell you what you want to hear is not a good friend, and they probably don't love you. But the person that will come and tell you about your life, the person that will come and tell you get it together, that's the person that you need to respect because they love you enough to tell you a hard truth. And the hard truth today is many people are not prepared for Jesus Christ, and he's coming so soon. Jesus Christ said he's gonna come like a thief in the night. What does that mean? That means many people are not gonna be prepared, and many people are not gonna be expecting when he returns. A lot of people think, oh, they've been saying that forever. They've been saying Jesus Christ is coming forever. God says, I suffer long with mankind. I desire that no one would perish, but that all would come to repentance. He says, as far as the east is from the west, that's how far I want to separate your sins from you. He said, I will take your sins. I will throw them into the sea of forgetfulness. I will remember them no more. He wants to forgive you. But if you reject Jesus Christ, how shall you escape judgment day? You can't keep running from the reality that judgment day is coming. Yes, it's coming. And if he doesn't come here, you surely will stand before him. If he doesn't come in your lifetime, there's still a time where we're going to all die and stand before him. But I'm telling you, he's coming very soon. It's very possible he could come in our lifetime. And then what? Look at what's happening in the world. You can't deny the things that are happening on this earth are happening at an unprecedented rate, a way we've never seen it before. Jesus Christ says, when you see these things happening, know that I'm coming soon. Know that I am nigh at the door. And then he says, behold, I stand at the door and I knock. If any man will open the door, I will come in. I will sup with him and him with me. He's knocking at our door every single day. If you don't step foot in front of a church, the church will come to you. He's knocking at the door of our heart every single day. If you're not religious, that's okay. I'm not religious either. I'm preaching to you about the message of truth, that Jesus Christ is real. This is not about a religion. This is about a relationship. The God who created heaven and earth is concerned about you. He said, think about the sparrows. We're talking about birds. He said, not one of them falls from the ground without me knowing about it. And aren't you more important to me than many sparrows? Aren't you more important to God than many birds? And if he can see every single bird that falls from the sky dead, do you think he can't see you? Do you think he's not concerned about your life? You think he doesn't know about the pain you've endured and the hurt you've endured? You think he doesn't care about it? A lot of people say, well, if God is real, why do evil things happen? Because God gave us free will, and we choose to do what we want. God has given us something to follow. He's given us the Ten Commandments to kind of let us know what his expectation is. Nobody can follow them flawlessly. That's why we need forgiveness. That's why only he fulfilled the law. But the Ten Commandments let us know what the standard is. And we've all fallen short of that standard. There's no such thing as little sin and big sin. It's are you guilty or are you not guilty? And the Bible says we're all going to stand before God. We're all going to be guilty on Judgment Day. That's me and that's you. Because he knows our thought life. He knows the secret sins you do when the doors are closed. He knows everything of your past. He knows everything of your future. And still he loves you. And still he says, come. He says, I don't condemn you. Think about the woman who was caught in adultery in the Bible. The prostitute who was caught in adultery. Everyone wanted to throw a stone at her. What did Jesus say? Many of you know this story. Jesus said, those who are without sin, cast the first stone. He was letting everyone know, we've all sinned. We've all fallen short. And no one threw a stone because everyone's conscience convicted them. They understood that we've all sinned. And then what did Jesus say? As they walked away, he approached the woman. He said, woman, where are your accusers? She said, nowhere, Lord. He said, neither do I accuse you. Go and sin no more. Jesus doesn't condone our sin. He extends mercy to us, and then he says, go and sin no more.